3:34 is echoed in both James 4:6 and 1 Peter 5:5, and this is what it says: God humbles the proud but gives grace to the humble. Or Jesus says it this way in Matthew 23:12, those who exalt themselves will be humbled, but those who humble themselves will be exalted. And here's the thing: you can either humble yourself or God will do it for you. And much more pleasant to do it yourself, to not think that you're all that, to not think that you're better than other people, but to humble yourself in God's sight, and he lifts you up, and he does remarkable things through you. None of us are all that special, quite honestly. But God is remarkable in that he chooses the humble to do his greatest work through. And then I want you to notice what she says next. God has filled the hungry with good things. Isn't that wonderful? What a great promise that God has filled the hungry with good things. But listen, he sent the rich away empty. I wonder, are you rich or hungry? And so when we think about that, you know, a survey was conducted by Schwab Modern Wealth Survey is what it was called. And it was published earlier this year, and they asked people across America, their customers, you know, how much does it take in order to be wealthy? And here's what they found. The average person in the survey said $1.9 million. If you have a net worth of $1.9 million, you're rich. But it's interesting, according to a Credit Suisse report, if you look at the entire world and you're in the top 10%, which would, I think, make you wealthy, make you rich, top 10%, You only have to have a net worth of $68,000. Now, the average net worth in America is $120,000. That's whatever equity you have in your house and your cars and whatever you have in the bank account, whatever you have in retirement, $120,000. By that standard, most Americans are rich, $68,000. To be in the top 50% of the world's population when it comes to wealth, all you have to have is a net worth of $3,000. And if you want to be in the top 1% of the world's population, you're going to find that you don't need 1.9 million, you just need 708,000, which sounds like a lot, but that might be for some people your house and your retirement fund. The truth is there's a whole lot of people out there who are in the top 1% of the world's population, and the reality is that almost all of us are rich in some way. We are rich by compared to the rest of the world and being the top 50%, or many of us are in the top 10%, and some of us are in the top 1%. We're rich. So what happens when the scripture says, when Mary sings, that he sends the rich away empty? And how does God go about making sure that the hungry are filled with good things? And the answer is the same in both cases. How do we avoid being sent away empty? How do we see God working to fulfill, to bring good things and fill good things, fill people who are hungry with good things? The answer is the same, and that is the people who have choose to be generous with what they have, and they share with people who don't have. And when they share with people who don't have, those who don't have find themselves filled with good things. And those who have been generous find that they're not sent away, but instead they did exactly what God intended for them to do.
Thanks for checking out the weekly sermon from Church of the Resurrection. I pray that God will use this message to speak to you and help you grow in your faith journey. If you're in the KC area, I'd like to invite you to join us next week at one of our services or join us in live worship online at core.org/worship. Church of the Resurrection is one church in multiple locations. To learn more about the service times and our ministries, please visit core.org. Hope you enjoy this week's message.